This ought to be a fun one to start with.
I didn't realize it was a ladder.
Of course it is. Because, you know, after all that last time, we definitely need...
No, it's a free-for-all. He's just so happy.
Yes, he is. He's just happy to be here.
Making his way to the ring from every man's nightmare, weighing in at 130 pounds, adorable Fane.
Yes, it is the adorable theme. I'm not sure your odd feelings on the money.
It is, these two have history. A lot of history.
The edgiest edge to edge around the edge. I think it'd be wise for me to make bets.
Probably not.
Probably shouldn't make bets.
We're not given enough sandwiches to pay for it.
Weighing in at 220 pounds, Gary D.
And the guardliest guard to ever guard around the guard.
Yes, Gary D. Lee. It's that Black Panther trademark from Marvel trademarks.
And people watching should be made aware that Gargoyle is not in fact fat. It's just a real heavy hoodie.
Yes, it is. All right.
Though he's looking pretty relaxed.
A little bit. Chase is very willing to just let them beat the hell out of each other. Hey, fuck it. I'm gonna go get this.
It's par for the course for Chase's, you know, let everyone else do the work. Probably still get beaten anyway.
And he starts wailing away on Gargoyle with the ladder.
On the feet. Gargoyle didn't like
that. And now he did a little march around the ring. And he comes back. Oh, his mortal enemy!
Even Fran doesn't like this.
Well, one of them is the adoring fan from Oblivion, one of them's an Argonian, the other one is Gargoyle the Guard. That's what's up with them. They're all Elder Scrolls themed, all of them. Knocks his head down on the ladder and then kicks the ladder out of the ring.
Again, par for the course.
Garden gnome. Well, gets him up, but nope, chases over the top.
The thing about garden gnomes is that they're generally made just for decoration, so you can't expect them to do too much.
Now please, during today's whole run of mess, please let me know what the quality is like, because like I said, trying something new.
Well, Fan actually setting up the ladder there.
Ace takes him down. Pops his leg back. Arm drag right off the floor.
Curl him halfway across the ring.
Goes up.
Going up top. But Gardley says, no thank you. And an electric chair drop.
Hang on, it says you're quiet for some reason.
I'm quiet?
Yeah.
Maybe because I'm not talking? I don't know.
Well, that's what these are, the early going is for, is to figure out what exactly I need to fix before we get going into the actual stuff.
I'm always quiet on these. I just figured that was because you wanted me to shut up.
No. Unbelievable.
Gardley going for it. This time, Chase says no.
Oh yeah, what is in the box, actually? What is... We have a suggestion here that it might be bento.
Fan and Chase is working together to get Gardley down from it.
Sweet rolls? Oh. If it's sweet rolls, that explains why Gardley's going for it. Oh!
Fan has the ladder.
Fan setting it up. He's the only one up. Oh, but he's gonna take some time to... Nope!
Chase says no. Chase is grandstanding when he should be climbing the damn ladder.
You had to think about it, you know? It's Chase's.
Fan is outside. If he didn't get back in there quick, then this could be over real fast. You need to do more than just punch him in the back of the knee. Fan, it's not gonna happen. What are you doing?
Man, come on. Oh, he finally caught him to let go. Oh! Oh, with a double team! Is he gonna let Gardley win?
I guess I'll do it myself. Fan again, just with those back of the knee punches.
Gardley let go of the case all on his own. But,
he really just doesn't want to make any serious attack. Eventually, Chase climbs the ladder and does it himself. Fan can't even push the ladder over.
He can't! He can't do it!
Your Chase has won.
Yep, Chase has won.
That's one way to win.
And he had no bets to win.
Well, I don't think anybody quite expected that the Fan couldn't even push a damn ladder over.
He just gave up.
I think that's where his overall 37 finally came into play.
All right.
I don't know if Chase's were fat, the ladder would have been easier to push over.
Okay, all right. So, now that we got that done, we'll get into our show proper here.
Well, that's one way to have an opener.
I just think it's funny as hell that he just completely gave up. Or Chase is too fat! He's fat!
I'm saying, if he were fat, it'd be one thing, but if he were fat, you'd be able to push the ladder over.
Alright, so today's lineup, we've got Gargoyle Gals versus Team Molag. We've got Tony and Brim throwing down.
Cat scratches everywhere.
Very much so. But instead of that, let's just get into it here. bring up the blocker. Yes, like I said, Gargoyle Gals versus Team Molag. Brim versus Tony. One of these snuck in, but we'll see how that goes. It's good for the soul sometimes. And wow, Hedgehog coming back with 1,200 sandwiches all on his own. Got the Douchebros returning to take on Heiko and his Nakama. We've got a rematch here with no black magic allowed. Seeing as last time was, most people were considering that Clara got robbed. We also got Queen Silver and Punchelf because, well, the right hand of justice has to take down the evil queen at some point. But we'll see if that happens.
You hope.
We'll see if it happens. And we've got Mord and Joe in a cage match.
More cat scratches.
Listen, cage is where friend become enemy.
And a well-deserved rematch.
Yes, indeed. No interference here. It's just one-on-one. All right, then. Well, let us start off here with the tag team match here, with returning a new tag team.
Is this a 2v3 or just a 2-on-2 with
it's a 2-on-2
bonus? Burn
yes.
Them all.
Go Token Mill, Bram Stoker's Dracula. You're, yeah, no, that's accurate. That's 100% accurate. Hello, Bohan. Glad y'all could make it. Overwhelming favoritism for the gargoyles I'm seeing. See if that
probably
pans
because
out.
People don't generally want Team Molag to win.
Probably not, but you know, we'll see what happens. Oh, it's all one word, Donna.
Gargoyle Gals.
Yeah, and Team Molag, all one word. All right.
The boo's already coming in hard.
As they do.
I was just checking on my end and I'm peeking my microphone, so I'm definitely not the one person who's quiet. In fact, it tells me I'm loud.
It's okay, I think I figured it out.
She's very neon.
Well, she is, like, glowing with molten fire, so...
That seems like a fire hazard.
Okay, we have at least one fire extinguisher here somewhere.
Somewhere over to your right there.
It's somewhere.
I don't know if we had it refilled recently, though.
Well, I mean, funny, they are made out of rock, so they have an excuse to be slow.
You just better hope that slowness doesn't carry over into their fighting style.
Who's gonna use the pizza cutter? No, our Domino's sponsorship!
Oh, Is she flailing her hands around because they're a little too hot today?
Just a little. I want to see where they come out of, because they're going to come out of the wall. Yep, they came out of the wall. Cameraman, please! You're zooming it too hard!
Oh, dear me. Let's get a better cameraman.
Oh, there they go. Stepping all over the audience.
One show without technical difficulties.
No. That's the nature of the beast, and we will not change things. It's a feature! Yep.
What is he looking all important for? He's not even in this fight. I'm just gonna stand there.
He's a valuable member of the team.
What, from our support?
Yes. Alright, starting off, Ashen Soul and Nebbia.
We'll see just how valuable his moral support ends up being.
Starting off with a board buster right out of the gate. I just missed walking. The vamps should get forks on their teeth. Why?
I mean, they don't really need them in this particular fight, given that their opponents are made of stone.
Yeah, Ashen Soul dropping the leg on Nebbia's arm.
When you're made of stone, you got to imagine a simple leg drop is going to hurt like hell.
And into one corner, ripping into the other towards Velika. Nope, spun back around. And we're going back to the other corner. Do-si-do, here we go. Oh, an early guy.
Apparently that was a mistake.
Nope, now, oh, almost nailing her partner there. Sunset flip powerbomb to the outside.
The amount of momentum that comes off of someone that's made of stone could not be a trifle, that's for sure.
Certainly not. Ashen Soul really starting off strong here.
There's a chair! As if any more solid objects were required. We're finally back in the ring. Not yet. Now back in the ring. Just taking a little bit of advantage of the apron first. I'm not entirely sure what she was going for there, but she certainly didn't get it.
Okay. Into the corner we go. Takes a tag out to her molten-armed friend.
I think it's lucky that their opponents are vampires, otherwise every touch would be burning. This sounds like some sort of a romance song from the 80s.
The snake eyes on that top turnbuckle.
Molag really just taking quite a beating here.
I feel like they're
naturally now I've made the comment. Things are turning around.
It's how it always is. Oh, spear with the reversal. Clubs to the back.
It's choking her down on that mat there.
Whoa, no!
Rolls
through! Just a one, though.
Just a one.
Spike from the powerbomb throws her across the ring!
surprised their hair doesn't just kind of come out when that happens.
I don't know.
Starting to work on those limbs now.
I'm sure she's pretty solid there, so.
But how does it even grow? And what's with this booing?
What is he, Molag? Nobody likes them.
Into the corner.
They get the tag here.
For a tag and a double team.
Won't you die?
That was incredibly well timed.
Those large stone fists coming down. Nearly hitting.
Why is there a, why is there a chair in the ring?
I believe that's what caused the booing. I think perhaps one of Team Molag threw it in with intent to see it used, but well, it clearly didn't work out that way. Simple punch and a kick to the back of the head. It really doesn't take much to do damage when your fists are made of stone.
How much does this guy weigh? I don't know. There's something like 300 pounds, I think, both of them.
Lifting the stone.
Well, I mean, Velika is nothing if not strong. Vampiric strength is a big bonus when you're fighting gargoyles like this. Oh, Lariato.
She's sizing her up.
Oh!
And she gets
it. A burning hammer? Oh, man! Hammer takes it!
I am honestly more shocked at how little damage it actually took to put her down for a three.
Hey, Burning Hammer's real strong. Also, Action Soul is cheating there, 1 foot over the rope. Oh, it was onto the chair, yeah! No, that's a good point, I didn't even see that.
I wouldn't say right onto the chair, it was more like a little onto the chair. It's a leg. If stone can't beat an aluminium metal chair, then what's the point?
Go ahead, barbed wire.
Yeah. I thought that was just a backstage chair.
I don't. See? And you know, I think Vlad threw that in, so you're talking about how, oh, he's going to be there for moral support. He did have something to do with the match.
Yeah, but he shouldn't have.
Yeah, well, ref didn't see it.
Ref doesn't see a whole lot in this game, in fairness.
Well,
pretty
so
sure
yeah.
All of our referees require glasses and don't have them.
Well, there you have it. Team Molag winning their first appearance back at the full team.
They're going to be even more full now. Full of themselves.
As they do. Yeah, no, they're not exactly known for being sporting. Not known for being fair, sporting, or, well, you know, just nice guys in general. Although Nebbia is. He's kind of the outlier.
Just because he's bigger, I wouldn't necessarily say that Tony is going to be the winner.
Oh, yeah, no. Like I mentioned earlier, Brim has a history with fighting people who are much larger.
He's very much the David, isn't he, of the...
Yes.
Of the tale.
Regardless, it would appear that audience opinion has Tony very well favored.
Apparently, to the extent of betting 5,000 in some cases.
Never count out the underdog with the fighting spirit, though.
I shouldn't say this, but I kind of hope Brim wins now, just to prove all these people wrong.
We're not gonna question what the white powder is.
Oh, man. Just chalk.
Just chalk, yeah, I'm sure.
Yeah, only two daddy, or only two bigs. Not three.
Yeah, no, it's the frosting for the flakes. Tony looking extra jacked today. With how many appearances he's had with Sackman recently, it's almost kind of strange to see him alone. But he definitely has been a singles competitor in the past.
He has indeed been the Husbando's champion in the past.
He's been... I think he's a Grand Slam champ. He's done everything. He's held every belt at some point that he could.
He has, yeah. Well, these days... He can hold literally every belt if he wants to give it a go.
Yep, that's how it works now. It's a quality, after all.
And if you don't think he's best waifu, then fucking fight me. 1v1 me.
Ooh. Brim looked like he was going for a powerbomb on the big man, but he got it reversed into a Rana.
Dodging the big foot, though. The size difference works both ways. It's important to remember.
And counters with a Frankensteiner. So tit for tat here already.
Thrown off. Absolutely thrown off.
The sunset flip. Again, the agility of Tony is not to be underestimated.
All kinds of fancy roundabout-y type moves today.
Just a couple of lucha cats. Sling blade from Tony.
The thing to remember about Tony is that...
Oh, that quick DDT and up on
really
his feet.
Solid DDT. The thing to remember about Tony is always that he's not just size. He's not just size and power. He has got mad agility. It's that advantage of being a cat more than anything. But...
Oh, Brim, up Brim. Top for the outside? Oh, he misses the fist drop.
All on four that of his limb. All four of his limbs hitting the ground there. But he is doing a pretty good job, or was doing a pretty good job of no-selling.
Every time you say something, that's what happens.
Can I just say a lot of things and see what happens then?
Yes.
Gee, Tony and Brim are both doing very well.
Good, now they're both gonna suck. Ooh, head onto the steps! Six. He's gonna try again! He's gonna try again! Was that a Phoenix Splash?
He failed. At landed his ribs first.
Yo, what is this?
On Tony's knees. Hit back, right back up again and turned it right around.
Inverted backbreaker? Brim going absolutely mental.
Six. You mean why is the twink on top and the bar on the bottom? Do you not know the wonder of having the Dom be the smaller one? It's a very common trope.
The hard shot right to the face, we're in an 8 count. These two are still
back again,
just rolling out here, kicking at his knees.
Is this a 20 count? It is a 20 count.
Ho ho ho! Cutter there from Brim.
With that height difference, that is a very low blow indeed.
Back into the ring we go after all of that. I say he's earned that.
Brim is in the mood for some murder, it would seem. Tony with a... Turn it around again. Of course, with all that size comes great stamina as well.
Or not, he's turning him back around.
Grim just punching him in the kidneys now. Getting a turnabout, though. And another reversal.
Shot for the drop kick, and unfortunately, he's a little bit too big. Goozled!
Uh-oh.
Oh, that big uppercut!
And the amount of times we've seen people put away with just that big right fist of his.
Nope!
But not this time.
I don't know why you're so surprised, Tony. But he's going for the real put away. Even bigger. He knocked him out.
We knocked him out clean. Well, I guess the crowd favorite did in fact win. But as a commentator, I think I'm going to go ahead and say I'm not entirely sure it was deserved.
That was a hard, hard, hard shot.
May well have been. I think Brim controlled the last portion of that match.
Well, Brim, as usual, showing that he's an absolute machine. But that right hand of Tony's is absolutely devastating.
His stamina, too. I mean, a lot of people would have been under a three count long before the end of that match.
Oh, okay, and now we get to see the game's brilliant writing. Let's see how this goes. This is a promo segment. I don't think you've ever seen this, Hedgehog. We had a problem with them a lot in the old game because you could not get around them, ever. And it would actually eat up a match slot. They don't now, but they rarely ever actually show up anymore, either. So let's see how this works. It was auto-booked, so I don't know what the specifics are.
That just makes it more fun.
Oh, she's already in the ring! I didn't even get to play her music! She's fast! Yeah, okay, thank you for the tutorial. I don't need the tutorial. Like I said, this is the first time we've seen it.
Damn, I love this city.
You've got Rock. Yeah, we do. We had two of them in the opener. Who's ready to party? Makes her living on manipulation. I thought we were friends. Who? Who are you talking about?
She got a combo bonus there.
Ava?
What?
Why are they chanting people's champ? Is the Dwayne here? People's champion.
The look on her face, she calls out, is Ava actually gonna come out? The best thing she could do is not bother. Why is her chest like undulating like water?
Don't ask questions. Physics are weird here.
Yes.
All right, she is out here, both of them. They forgot to give her a mic, so she had to go pick one up.
Hello, my name is Ava.
Ghosts can't talk. ArcNXT universe. our subtitlers are aiming high for another job. Are they chanting asshole?
What you mean? I appreciate the interruption.
You called her out here. Even she can't believe it. It was like, the fuck?
You literally just invited me to the ring.
Real slow up to the mouth, like, I don't even know what to say.
Set
up. I'm talking backstage. She one of us said that was so boring. I fell asleep, sleepwalk my way out to the ring. I can't believe she's a sleepwalker. What the hell is the crowd chanting?
What is cute? No, but enough is enough. Now you're pissing me off.
You don't want to know what happened when I'm really pissed off. We did find out what
usually
happened.
Usually, when she's really pissed off, doesn't she just go and have sex with someone she shouldn't?
I mean, with a match with Suzette after waiting for her entrance, she was so mad she just slaughtered her, so.
You want to think you're big and tough?
You want to be me? You even have my poster hung up in your dressing room! What? Ava has posters! Is it just a picture of a goat on the tower?
She's beaten into Arurun's dressing room? Clearly cut off on the wrong foot.
Why is she screaming at tits? She's so confused!
Why is she taking longer to say the tiny short line than she does to say the ones that you can't even read in time?
There's a revolution happening. People like you, you're gonna be the first ones to go. Oh my god. That's on brand. Goats are originally a terrorist cell, so I mean that sounds right to me. I wish these were voice acted. You think you're the best?
I think you're the best.
Time will tell. Only the best can get through me. In the right mind believes you stand a chance against me. Became the number two. You're the number one contender. No, you're not.
No, you're not.
Ava Mordessa is the number one contender. What the fuck? Arurun doesn't know what to say because Ava's just clearly bullshitting.
Well, everyone lost. Apparently, it was bullshitting power.
Nice high promo was better than what we just read. God, that was something else. The writers for this are on some next level shit. Okay, all right. Well, after that, whatever the hell that was, we're gonna move on to this next tag team contest.
Ah, yes. Dude Bros versus Dude.
I get John Cena. Actually, that's kinda neat. Shame John Cena's a traitor to the country. Anyways.
Ava was like, I've been in your locker room. Yes, yes, she was.
I like that Ava got through that and got more out of that just because she just started talking complete nonsense.
The funny part is, it's not just that she's not the number one contender now. She never has been.
What the fuck was she doing in there? I don't know.
Don't worry, Brim. By missing your match, you also missed the outcome.
Alright, let's do this one here.
By Azura, by Azura, by Azura.
All right.
You did, yes.
Looking as douchey as ever. Four things change, but what do they say?
I'm sorry, what? But what boots with attitude?
Bad boots with attitude.
That exact synchronization when they got into the ring.
And say what you want about these guys, but they do have great teamwork.
Absolutely terrifying the crowd look when they stand up out of their seats.
Yeah, a little bit.
They just kind of float up. It's disturbing.
Look at Moi. He traveled a long way to be here.
Rob being here, I can tell. The thing that troubles me the most about Heiko's vest there is that the vest itself has muscles sewn into the shape. You can tell because it has loose edges.
Yeah, well, you know, you gotta look good.
It's not his own six-pack, it's...
Yeah, he
sorry,
didn't get it.
Sorry, Heiko.
He didn't get part of it. She took it from him. Big Daddy Quad, yep.
Is there just a little gap in his hair there?
The joke here, yeah, I don't understand what that's about. The joke here is, and it's not on the other side. The joke is that they both have different match entrances. He attempted to start off with a big lariat rider, dodging out of the way, and a dropkick directly to the face.
Rider certainly starting out with a lot of force, but pulling her away from his own corner now is interesting choice.
Israel had a decent history, honestly. They did end up making it to Dragon Ball one time. Off the middle rope with a bulldog. This guy thinks he's Orange Cassidy.
One unfortunate downside for him landing face first from something like a bulldog is that he never takes those glasses off.
Yeah, he never does, but I gotta imagine they're reinforced after all this time. He's done some forethinking.
Oh, I'm sure they won't break, but they'll definitely transfer extra force to the rest of his face. I imagine when he goes to bed at night and takes them off, there's just like a hole, a line gouged in his forehead from me.
Guys like these always seem like the kind of drug dealers to spike your weed. I don't think Ryder ever takes his sunglasses off.
Yeah.
Oh, face first with force.
She did not take kindly to it. He was gonna go over for the tag, it looked like, but she said no.
Yeah, she said absolutely not.
Throwing Z to the ground while the ref is right. What's
a bit of a bit of miscommunication there, body language wise, I think. It's tag out to Heiko.
Heiko.
That is a boot to the face from Wilhelm Lariato into the corner. What, he's choking him!
Right there in front of Z, you'd think she'd be taking the time to maybe...
Well, it looks like she's just more berating him for letting himself get choked in the first place. I feel like that's on... I think
get up from there, you little bitch!
I feel like that's very on brand. Get him into the middle of the ring. Both legs up. Straight up off the ground. Oh. Spikes him with a powerbomb. I thought he was going to go for another one.
I think he was trying, but his opponent had other plans.
That is Wilhelm. That's one of Nico's characters. Speaking of the quad, oof! Right on the leg. All that pain transfers straight up through the knee and the quads.
Looks like there's going to be a little double team action now. Or
why
not.
Does he know?
He dragged him all the way over there and then did nothing about it.
Ryder's the one with the forethought, not Wilhelm.
I'm not sure Wilhelm has much of anything.
He always got a cool choke slam onto his knee! Oh, he's got him with the captain's anchor! Legs absolutely wrenched back! He's not going anywhere!
Not coming in to help. I guess he had faith in his partner.
He's got a little more faith than that. Whoa! And Ryder, for good reason. Ryder scouting him up. Classic DDT! Heiko went near vertical after that. Pulled him over, hooks the legs. D's in quickly enough to break it up.
Now, getting a little bit of fallout from that. Rolling herself out of the ring while Heiko just lays there. Left to take even more damage.
Oh, knee in the face, eyes up on the middle rope.
And some boots to the face, too. And
a flying elbow.
Elbow. Yeah, sure. That's what that bloody part is.
Fist elbow, there's lots of it. Butterflies to play! Heiko still somehow managing to go here. Into the corner. No!
Oh.
Beat has suddenly picked way up here.
Z on the outside, having terrible trouble getting herself back to her position. Well, Heiko is,
I think I just heard Heiko's arm or head collide with the steps.
Something did, yeah. Ryder is just kind of falling over. An awful lot of back and forth here on the outside. Oh, Heiko just throwing him into that post. Heiko.
They're up to an 8 count now.
Still just completely back and forth. Well, help me, I just enjoy watching Ryder kind of flop over. He finally managed to get that tag and get Wilhelm in there.
And we'll see if Wilhelm can actually capitalize.
Heiko kind of repeatedly no-selling there. A rope break on top of that. Heiko says no.
Over, but then catches a kick right to the head.
Ryder with a couple of missed kicks on the ground there.
The worst part is Heiko warps to his feet. Got him goozled again on the knee. Ryder's nowhere to be seen, but he tags out to G instead. She gets to get the glory here. No, only
just
one
count. That was surprising. He can't have an awful lot of fuel left in his tank at this stage.
No,
he's taken plenty of beating while he's been in the ring.
Why he's standing here trying to catch his breath.
Unfortunately, every moment that he stands there catching his breath is also a moment that his opponent catches their breath, so it doesn't necessarily work out in his favor, although he has managed to make something of it so far. Heiko on the outside there having terrible trouble even staying standing. G making that smart little slide out of the ring to give herself a moment to collect.
Fisherman suplex, but again, no love on it at all.
And
Wilhelm's content
again,
to just stand there.
Ryder having his own trouble over there as well. Wilhelm just consistently passing up his chances to pin. It makes you wonder if he's trying to kind of play with his food now, or...
Well, that is a douche thing to do. Wouldn't surprise me.
She's certainly not content to let him, though. She's certainly given as good as she gets.
Back on the outside, big knee lift.
Up until now, every punch had been a punch in return, but Wilhelm's starting to get a little more of that momentum, I was going to say, but there...
Rocks him like a stone on the outside. But Wall manages to recuperate enough to fight back here. Kicks to the gut over and over again and slams him onto the apron face first.
Reversal after reversal after reversal.
Up to a 10 count.
At this point, all four of our contenders have nothing but fumes left.
Looks like Heiko's had enough.
I don't think he wants the count to end up in a disqualification.
Or he does. I think at this point, 15. They're at 15.
15
and
count.
G is more than happy to just beat him up to a draw out here.
Wilhelm looking like he's trying to actually get back in the ring now.
Yeah, she was perfectly willing to just beat the hell out of him out there until it came down to...
I think at this point she was more interested in just putting the hurt on him, not actually winning the match. Now they're just standing there because they're so utterly exhausted.
Yeah, well, I mean, he always takes a chance to trash talk, so hey. Oh, got him up for the fisherman's, but he punched her in the gut instead. Is she gonna try it anyways? Oh! Ooh. Was that a muscle buster? Hooks the leg. Two. No!
Still a kick out. Where is this even coming from? Where can he possibly have the energy left to be able to kick out?
She has had more than enough. She is
taking no more of this crap. She is going to kill him whether he wants it or not. He's still trying to crawl for that.
He did get the tag.
I think Z may want to get a tag of her own, otherwise she's going to be down and out.
Got her with the butterfly all the way over his head.
Ryder's had a lot of chance to rest up in his corner, so he's going to be a lot fresher than Z right now. Still, for some reason, not taking the chance to pin, though.
And that may have been the killer mistake, Fisherman Suplex.
She's not done yet, though. Setting him over into the corner.
The corner misses.
Misses. Ryder again just standing there, though, refusing to take that pin. So.
Is the back of his leg missing?
Who's?
Yeah, it is. There's a mesh around the back of his leg.
Yeah. Maybe that's why he's.
What the fuck?
We don't ask questions here.
He's been away a while.
Again,
maybe that's win.
Just these one reversals the in the corner now.
Look at that neckbreaker.
Z may finally be in for a pin very shortly if she can't get to Heiko.
Oh, that roaring elbow!
He's still not pinning her, though. I don't know. Why is Wilhelm getting mad at Ryder now?
An idiot sandwich.
Well, there he goes! Pin. He had to be told explicitly, and no!
And she kicked out! Jesus! I mean... Why is your shit out of there?
Is he gonna be able to make it for that distance? Maybe so, we'll see. Is he gonna be able to make it? Oh, coup de grace! And he hooks the leg! How? How is she still fighting out? What is she made of?
Heiko didn't even make it to her. She just plain kicked out. I cannot believe the amount of resilience on this girl. Ryder still, he barely even able to stay standing. Finally a tag into Heiko, who immediately flattens Ryder.
She's just running on spite. Yeah, that sounds on brand. Samoan drop. Into the corner, setting
Heiko
up for something.
Waiting for Ryder to stumble.
Oh, that discus big boot absolutely just flattens him.
Heiko pulling him all the way across the ring. Pinning intent is clear.
Is Will going to build it? Yes, he did make it there in time.
Makes it in time. Unfortunately, Z is
still
he's
pissed.
Recouping on the outside. Heiko not letting the... trying not to let the momentum go.
Inverted brain buster, looks like. Wilhelm finally out of juice completely over there. Looks like he wasted all he had left on that interrupt.
Heiko getting kind of flung across the ring by Ryder now.
And putting on the Iron Man classic here. You got him in a nerve hold?
He's got him in a nerve pinch. I'm not sure how much Ryder has left. Ryder fall out
like
of
I
it.
Said,
this is
Oh.
Double tag.
Well, both of them now going into the corner. Oh! He's tuning it up!
This may be all she wrote.
Sweet douche music!
Super kick. Whatever that is.
What a name. Two. And Wilhelm finally ends it there with that super kick.
An incredibly hard fight on both sides.
Exceptionally hard fought, yes.
Honestly, every kick out for about the last five was just another piece of unexpected.
I did not expect him to go quite that hard here. That's the longest single tag match I think I've seen so far.
I don't know. Drawn out usually implies that things are slow. I think every moment of that was about 100 miles a minute, except for when Ryder just kept standing there doing nothing.
That's fantastic, boy. All right. Damn. I mean, it makes sense to me. Gee, with that just unbelievable spite to not lose. And Douchebros, like I said, they've proven themselves before to be top competitors in tag teams. They've managed to make it to the top, but never really secure it many times before. They've had a few shots at the tag titles, but I think the last time was when it was in the Somerset Stormbringers hands, because of course it was. And at that point, they were still in their completely unbeatable phase.
I don't recall that particular match even lasting all that long.
All right, yes, no black magic today whatsoever. Not allowed.
The following contest 4,000 on Lenore.
And it's for the women's extreme.
I see your strategy there, Hedgehog. We'll see if it pays off for you. Never give up.
Honestly, without any strange trickery, I think the match would be quite interesting in terms of potential outcomes.
Yeah, I mean, there is a... Clara, again, has proven herself time and time and time again against many different competitors. I feel like she has a strong chance here, but... this is her last chance for a while. If she doesn't get it here, it's going to go on the next set of contenders. And like I said, the next...
We're all the way back up from the bottom again.
Yep. Next in line is Mordessa, because she has also really proven herself. Yep, here she is, the Waifus champ once and then again.
Quite a range of bet sizes here.
Yeah, very. Lenore is absolutely winning in terms of the amount of that spell. Clara, the underdog, once again. We'll see how this pans out. I don't ironically want that, like, close kind of thing. Yeah.
My bet's on the sandwich.
Well, the sandwich is always good. He's just happy to be here. I never mentioned
the
how happy I am with that title belt design.
A number of times.
The challenger from Helsinki, Finland.
A lot to be proud about, aren't I?
Cheryl Steele Walters.
There is real pumped here, real excited.
From the other side of Lenore looks just kind of pissed off that she has to defend against the same person again.
And she doesn't get her gimmick.
Undisputed champion, the necromancer, Leo Moore.
My favorite thing with Lenore coming back to it is that she got the belt immediately because she just annihilated Galena. Like, she just had enough.
Yep, that's a belt.
Belt.
Today, the referee has won the women's belt. The referee is the best waifu today.
Red Shoes is pretty fantastic. Run up the back and forth. Or got her into a headlock. Against the ropes, off the ropes! Up down.
Glitching to the left. Clara starting to come out with some fire in here.
Very much so. Russian light sweep, everyone's gotta do one once at least.
I think it wasn't just the viewers that were bitter about the ending of the last match.
Oh no, Clara seems kinda sour about it too, but chest first into the top turnbuckle and just throw him against the ropes.
Kick to the head from those go faster booties.
Lenore missing,
but taking a shot.
Lenore's a little too slow for Clara. They're firing back.
Fist to the forehead, man.
Oh, over the ropes, but hangs on.
But she's not letting go. Flung back in. Lenore putting her brute force on show here. A little early for a cover.
And momentum could swing one way or the other at any time here, so we'll see what happens. Ooh, answering back for that boot earlier.
Speaking of momentum.
A little dance.
Chin to the top of her skull there.
Single leg dropkick. Clara, again, just firing in all cylinders here. But Lenore, no!
Pumping on that solar plexus.
Own tough customer. To the corner, is it already time for Around the World?
Yeah,
yes, it is!
It really is! Kick to the face.
Boots her in the face, and she is continually brutalizing her with the shoes. Going up already for the shooting star?
She's
Clara with a shooting star already, too!
A two count this early in the night. She is absolutely blaming the passion.
She's going
up again! Lenore getting up to her feet now, though. Clara's...
Oh, this is the missile dropkick. Lenore playing possum, possibly.
Seem like the way time to start with the grandstand.
Into the corner. Oh!
Go to the face for her attempts.
Snapmare? Little Shining Wizard.
Absolutely putting those little red boots to their best possible use.
The corner again. Oh, Lenore showing some genuine frustration and exhaustion here. I don't think she expected Clara to come back quite so hard.
Reversal and another reversal.
Every time she lifts her up like that, I keep expecting it's the tombstone to follow slam right into the ref's legs.
The ref just shook it off.
Oh, she's going up.
Clara lamenting her back here, but kind of rolling and flailing around.
Calling her up to her feet. Blind elbow drop right to the neck. Hooks the leg. Two, only two.
Just the two. Very short two as well. There was no question in that kick out.
Wrenching on the neck.
In one of the worst places to have.
Oh, here it comes. Got her for the sleeping tombstone. Crosses the arms, rest in peace. And Lenore takes it again.
Well, there was certainly no foul play suspected this time. But I have to say, the effort on either side was not particularly proportional. You forgot your belt, Lenore.
You did forget it, but she forgot something else too, it looks like. She's got a little barbed wire chair laid into Clara!
Boom wasn't enough. No, she had to brutalize her and absolutely break her spirit.
Yeah, to send a message that you do not get more than one attempt with me. That's it.
It'll certainly be interesting to see how the next contender takes her on.
What did we learn?
Lenore's kind of a bitch.
What we learned is don't fuck with the French.
Are you kidding? That's exactly the opposite of what we learned.
No,
what we learned is that the French need to be put in their places.
Well, we'll find out how that works out later.
We'll see how Mord does on that particular task.
Yes, Mord, number one contender. Punchelf here, number two contender. So they are both possibly looking to score off themselves to see who gets the right to go after Lenore. At this point, I feel like Lenore might need more than one person to keep her down at once. All right.
Oh, I have a sneaking suspicion that whoever does finally take it from her is going to do it very swiftly and solidly. It'll be the kind of match, I think, where someone just outdoes her purely on moveset alone. You know how it be. There's just that one person who absolutely destroys them unexpectedly.
Oh, very confident in Punchelf. Silver, very disdainful of literally everyone here. As she does.
Literally everyone here quite disdainful of her as well, from the sound of things.
Gonna be bankruptcy for somebody.
One of these days, I'll get that 343 sandwiches.
You got 343 sandwiches.
The upsetting part is that I can't eat them.
I'm gonna redeem you if we don't.
How many sandwiches here do I actually need to get my sandwiches there?
The exchange rate's foggy. Not clear.
Punchelf coming in like she just means business.
100% business, all determination and fire.
We don't have pyro, but we do have lights.
We have lots of those. Yeah, you would think they would
be sponsored by a neon light company.
You would think they'd have Wes on pyro and not concessions, but this is how it worked out.
Well, Silver coming out swinging.
Yeah, Silver extremely strong here in the early going. Not quite a neckbreaker, I almost said it's a stunner. Wes isn't getting paid much. She's getting paid in handshakes and hot dogs as well, but she's pleased with it.
Yeah, Wes doesn't actually quite understand that most people are paid in currency.
Oh, a little bit of a taunt there. Loving over hands and throws her out with that clothesline. For as strong as Silver started off, Punchel's firing back.
Well, you know, one of the biggest risks in one of the biggest risks in any kind of fight with Punchelf is taking her lightly. That's for certain.
Oh, fires back with her own chop. Goes for the forearm, denied.
Silver is attempting to get some momentum back in here. Finally gets a couple of hits.
Back of the head on the mat.
The pathetic flop over.
Nine. As the gut punch grabs the leg. Single leg Boston Crab on the outside. Not gonna get a victory here, but definitely gonna wear her down.
Getting
12 count.
Kicked off rather unceremoniously there. And finally heading back toward the ring.
Ooh!
Silver missing.
Her throat hangs her up on the ropes. He directly to the small of the back.
And getting her thorax pushed in against those springy ropes as well at the same time.
No! High angle slam from Punchelf.
The humans have thoraxes.
I don't
believe so. Like that was...
Now's not the time to strut.
Silver is a bug now.
I don't know, bug Silver sounds kind of cool to me. Drops her on the back of the head from up on the rope.
Silver pulling out all the stops.
Yeah, Silver looks like she's had more than enough. Oh, she's going in the corner. This is the same thing.
Getting ready for it.
KO'd another elf. So let's see if she can pull the same again. Knee right to the head.
It did take more than one last time, though.
But it only took one this time. Silver on an undefeated streak so far. 3 wins in a row.
And that was a very swift match as well. Boy, the waiting on that dress.
It's not the best.
Punchelf absolutely devastated at losing quite so quickly here, I think, more than anything. And Silver is not done yet.
No, she's disappointed she didn't get the knockout this time.
So apparently she's just going to go for it now instead.
It sure seems like it.
Now Punch Elf certainly does seem to have passed out right at the end there, after that collision with the steps.
Well, Silver showing that she's definitely not just, all showing no go. She's definitely got that mean streak.
Well, considering who we're talking about, it's not exactly shocking.
Yeah, I'd say. Just a quick question for everyone. The quality is good, right? It's not, we're not having issues.
I'm running it on 1080 on my other screen and it looks fine.
Okay, yeah, because when I said we're trying something different, I meant we're trying it at 1080-60 today. So, so I was a little worried about that.
Yeah, I don't know whether it's the specific time of day that we do this now or what, but I actually don't have the issues that I used to have on the Twitch side of things.
Twitch might have also improved over time, too.
I think it's more likely that it's early enough in the day that the American...
No, Miko streams here now sometimes, so it's definitely improved.
Oh, fair enough.
Just because Miko's here, I mean. Anyways, all right. Steel cage match between two cats who are supposed to be friends, but as you know, friend become enemy in cage.
Just more cat scratch fever.
Glad we didn't even get to see that.
More Teresa?
More Teresa.
Not just Teresa, more Teresa. Very athletic entrance into the ring there.
Yes, Mord is absolutely athletic and goes very, very hard when required. As we saw from her beating down Servile back into Sense. Joe's ever noticed that tag at the social media handle. Can't have less Teresa, can we?
How do you know? We could have less Teresa. Have you tried it?
Hopefully not. One way or the other, if there is, I'll deal with it when I come to that bridge. And hello, 1216, nice to have you back. We're getting towards the end here, but I feel like we might have a bonus match at the end. I don't know who's going to be in it, but it'll probably be Mudcrab.
It's okay. I prefer this entrance music to Joe anyway.
Yeah, it doesn't really matter now that Shio's not really a part of it. Even though we are still selling the Shio phones, we have a lot of back stock.
They're your mud crabs.
Oh! Mud crabs. Yes, indeed. We have plenty of mud crabs just milling about the building in the back.
They're actually a delicacy in Knox.
Joe.
He doesn't want to get beaten.
I mean, it's reasonable.
Seeing what she did to Sir Knight the other day, I mean, I wouldn't blame him.
Northern Lights who play.
Ha!
And Mort says, well, fine, screw it, I'll just leave too.
The biggest thing that always gets me about that particular reversal is the potential for them to literally bite their own tongues off when that, the top of that head collides with their jaw.
Yeah, there are a lot of things, wrestling-wise, that could go wrong. Thankfully, we don't have a medical department, so we don't have to worry about it. It's someone else's problem if it happens. And yes, though, those are... He is in the king colors. Oh!
Danny missed.
He missed this by a teeny bit, but it's kind of cool that he went back to do it.
Making the attempt just ultimately... Getting his knees slammed again. Oh! Oh, like face first.
Bombs right on his smarmy face. As everyone knows, Joe is a villain, reprehensible, utterly Northern Light suplex, but although he does do the Northern Light suplex, my favorite, so you know. Can't be too bad.
Once again.
There, he's got it that time!
Did it this time.
Wrenching the arm around, rolls the shoulder! That one always looks like it hurts.
Begging for a dislocation.
Tiny little attitude adjustment. Butterfly. Backbreaker.
Onto the knee.
Yeah, I'm glad the King design worked out well. I wasn't trying to go for an exact one, but it has panned out pretty well, I think. Boing, boing, and was it a 6:30? Hooks the leg. Just a two.
Just to get that momentum and swing around.
Oh, forfeiting. Oh. I guess I'm overestimating because if you don't do a 6:30, you're a coward.
His elbows to the back of the head and shoulders there.
Pump handle, over on the shoulder! A spinning Samoan drop. Joe says, that's it, I'm done, I'm out.
He may be right as well.
He may be, but Mort is getting back.
Mort's
getting back up.
She's up, but can she catch him? I don't think she can. I think that's it.
Climbing back up. Catches him on the knee.
At the very last possible moment, we're having a...
Oh!
No,
boots her in the face, and I think that's it. I think she's out.
As long as Joe can stop flapping around like a fool.
He did manage to stop flapping around like a fool, and Joe climbs down the cage. Just got to put both feet on the floor, and Joe wins. Yes, Joe, the dastard, the villain, wins.
Indeed.
After kicking a little cat in the head to knock her off the top of the cage.
Unfortunately, sometimes that's just the way things go. This is, in reality, the good guy doesn't always win.
That poor video friend closed. And Joe had absolutely no one bet on him, so everyone just lost on that one.
Joe himself even looks somewhat surprised about the situation.
What crap response? Look at that smarmy bastard.
He'll get his.
I bet he's gonna go burn down an orphanage after this instead of save an orphanage like King. Of burning down orphanages. The homunculi on the right definitely would be up for burning orphanages.
I feel the urge to ask him just how many orphanages he's burned down in his life.
Do you remember how many orphanages you burned in your life?
I feel like it'd be the sort of question as asking me how many loaves of bread I've eaten in my life, you know?
Yeah, I imagine so.
Do you remember how much evil you've done?
Aylen just remember how much you breathed? Nayan, currently holder of two top titles, both the Arena Grand Championship and the ArcNXT Championship.
Yeah, personally, I think we should have done a double again here, but hey.
It's not allowed.
The following contest
sure it
is a knockout match. The first
I mean, I'm all for Aylen taking both belts with him on the way out if he wins.
Will win the match. And it's for the full Grand Prix Ultraviolent Lucha Championship.
Yeah. Maybe I'm showing a little personal bias here, but...
Hey, Aylen's a good guy. He doesn't look quite as enthusiastic as usual, but after last Saturday, I guess I would have the win taken out of my sails, too.
He's got a chance to get them back in his sails here, and I hope he doesn't waste them. Are you going to spend all? I should have done that. I probably have like 10 more sandwiches now.
Fan has disappeared again, which means he's probably been again.
Nah, he's probably just gone back to hiding. Nayan seems the type that doesn't actually come to the arena until even if they force his match. So Fan was okay with coming out for the pre-show, you know?
We've been talking about with newcomers really being on fire all the way in. Mike and Clara, although Nayan has definitely capitalized on Nayan has been more or less on top of the league. No loss,
what? I didn't even realize he lost.
He took all the fan strength. That makes sense. That's a little concerning here, but we'll see if that has any effect on the outcome.
From the old country.
Aylen, what the hell is going on with your hair?
It's reflecting the light.
Gladiator, Aiden
A. What the hell are you doing with your hands?
Alternatively, he's powered up and turned neon in order to beat the evil.
He's doing a spiritual haka over there.
From every man's nightmare.
From every man's nightmare.
Lots of sandwiches riding on Aylen right now.
The Dominator.
No, they shouldn't ride on him. He'll fall over.
Men dream of him. Well, I mean, if you ask Nayan, probably. Aylen losing the title has changed him in more ways than one. He did have that title with him for quite some time.
Yes, now he's neon.
Alright, one-on-one contest. Hits him with the knee strike right out of the gate. Mocking him. Ooh, and Aylen returning with a knee of his own.
giving as good as he gets. And just giving him the really stay on the ground where you belong treatment here.
Not the most surprising, dodges the kick into the corner.
Aylen unable to build up any steam here. It's either reverses or being on the receiving end.
Middle roll kicks him in the face!
That is a very big boot to be coming down on your head from that height.
Down the Nayan master of submission holds. Very concerning if he manages to lock anything in.
Aylen trying for a pin very early. I mean, it was a one, which is already more than I'd expect.
Versus boots in the knee, catches the leg.
One reversal after another. They're just back and forth, back and forth.
Very much so, floats over DDT.
Well, Aylen does seem to be the one getting off the larger moves. You have to wonder if that's having any effect on the long term.
We saw earlier today, it doesn't quite matter if you get all your shit in quick. It can turn around with one big move, like with Tony and Brim.
Absolutely.
Aylen going for high risk to the outside. He better be sure he hits this, because if he doesn't, he's in for a lot of pain. He went right over the top of him. Hey, at least he landed on his feet.
He landed on his feet. That you could, it could have gone worse.
Let's judge the distance, I suppose.
In literal terms, I think it might be more like he couldn't connect there because the game wouldn't let him.
Let's judge the distance. Game's fine.
Man, wrenching that neck there.
Wrenching it again. I thought he was going to do it a third time.
I was kind of thinking the same myself. He does have that air of someone who wins by pressing the same button over and over again, you know what I mean?
Triangle dropkick directly to the head.
Flipping over the ropes to get back in. Going for a pin.
Only one, not only even one.
Aylen's got more in the tank yet. Though the question of whether he can get up and start using it is another matter entirely. Oh, man. Scouting him out.
And I am might be going for that leg trip. No, no,
but
no!
Aylen get it. Aylen
get shots up! Ooh, he busted him open too.
That's a rope break.
Two. Oh.
Ooh. Aylen caught him in the middle of his vile plan. Made a mockery of his scout out. That's for sure.
He bleeds. To the gut, off the ropes, single leg drop kick.
Drop
another
kick.
One.
And another one.
It's in swinging neckbreaker.
Aylen getting his momentum up and keeping it up now. Kick to that back there.
Trying the to leg.
Another kick out faster than last time.
It's fan. It's the fans' blood, stopping. More than likely. No! Turns it into a bulldog on him.
Bulldog. Aylen really not taking no for an answer this time.
Drags him into the center. Oh, he's getting ready. Kinshasa! Hooks the leg.
One.
Two.
Two.
And Aylen picks up all the gold.
Oh, that was
100%
an absolute curb stop of a match. If anyone at the end of this match has to be saying stay on the ground where you belong, I believe it's Aylen.
I attribute that almost solely to the fact that he scouted out that SDF camel clutch, that submission that has taken him down twice now, and instead returned with that mighty Kinshasa that knee right across the face.
Right when Nayan thought he was gonna get it in the bag, Aylen, you know, had that wherewithal to just turn it around on him, and boy did he. He capitalized on it.
Camera? Whoa! Aylen! Takes it back! Were you insane? Or so not? Oh, who got all those? Oh, close it out with a championship win with seven. Seven! Total of 50 more! Oh, which is fucking jiggling, angry. Oh, it's in the right box, bro. Anikabar and Sova. And Sky Shadow. That's a cool name. And AI 340, who is probably one of the AIs running this. Oh boy. Okay, well.
That was quite the outcome.
Yeah. Seriously.
I wasn't expecting him to put such an absolute stomping on my hand, but I think that kind of tells us what way the match will turn out when there aren't two other people on the outside.
Right. Well, Aylen is absolutely a Terminator, and he showed it here today. Our Arena Grand Champion and ArcNXT Champion now, Aylen.
The fan can finally come out from the...
He can be with his kid. Yeah. Alright, that is our show proper. Stick around for a bonus match, maybe one or two.
Don't forget to declare the winner.
But yes, we had a Lenore hanging on doggedly to her title. Aylen taking his back and then some. Queen Silver's still on her boring rampage. And Douchebros showing that they can go for a long time.
They've got stamina, you know what I mean?
Yep. Alright, well. For those of you who would like to exit the building now, thank you for watching. Thank you for coming to the show. And again, if you want to stick around for more matches, by all means.
For those of you who want to see mud crabs, feel free to stay.